Hi, welcome to this video. In this video I will show you how to create a backup server with the PenMedia Vault NAS. This way you can backup the entire operating system or data. This is my PenMedia Vault NAS server and has Docker and Portainer pre-installed. I will deploy a new container first. To build the backup server, I use a backup. You go to the home page of Rebackup and see the instructions to install it on Docker. Set the image to your own /backup server. Next is to set the port for backup. TCP ports used are 5 years 413 and 55414. Only one UDP port used is 35623. With your backup, you can backup and restore over the internet if set up properly. Next, set up the network as host. Restart and policy set to unless stop. The setup is complete, you click deploy the container. After about a minute, the container deployed successfully. You check the log to make sure there are no errors. Thus there is no error with your backup container. To access your backup management website, open a new tab and enter the NAS server IP address and port 55414. By default, your backup doesn't have a login password, but I recommend you to create one. But with the default container creation like this, the storage capacity of your backup server will be very little, so you need to edit the path to the larger storage of the NAS server. To do that, you edit the volume of your backup container. On the PenMedia Vault NAS server, I will merge 3 hard drives into one for large storage capacity. Specifically, in this example, I combine 2 1TB hard drives and 1 500GB hard drive. After merging the hard drives, I created a new shared folder. The new shared folder is called Backup and uses storage pooled from 3 separate hard drives. Total storage capacity is about 2.2 terabytes. This is the path to the newly created folder. We will use this path to set up your backup container. With volume/backups you set bind. Then you copy and paste the path here. After updating the path, you deploy the container. The new container will replace the older backup container. Open the log and make sure no errors occur. You refresh the backup management web page and make sure no error message appears. You have successfully built your own backup server on the NAS server. So, how to backup a Windows computer? Please join me in the next part of the video. You go to your backup homepage and download the client installer for Windows computers. A small installation file is downloaded. You open the installer and click Next a few times to complete the installation for the client. You may be asked to restart your computer to complete the installation. I recommend that you follow the instructions to avoid errors when backing up. The Windows computer will automatically detect the server in the local network and the computer will be backed up for the first time. As in this example, the Windows client automatically finds the server whose IP address is 10.11.32.26. By default, Partition C contains the Windows operating system that automatically backs up to your backup server. You can easily monitor the backup process, backup speed. While the computer is backup, you can use your Windows computer normally. Your backup doesn't interrupt your work while backing up. You go to the Appendia Vault Management page and check the change in the available free space on the hard drives. And you will see if the backup files have been saved to the folder you specified. If you want to know how to backup a specified file or folder, then watch at the end of this video. Next, I will show you how to restore your computer from a backed up image. To do that, you need a USB stick with at least 1 GB capacity. Here I have an 8 GB USB stick. Next, go to your backup homepage and download your backup recovery CD. There are many utilities to help you create or backup USB recovery stick, but I am used to using Rufus tool. I also recommend you to use the Balina Etcher tool because it's faster. The nice thing about using Rufus is that you don't have to install it on your computer. After getting the USB recovery or backup stick, you plug it into the computer you want to restore from the backed up image. You connect the computer you want to restore to the same local network as your backup server. In other words, you connect the Windows computer you want to restore to the same local network as the Appendia Vault NAS. Start your backup restore. There are two recovery options for you to choose from: the graphical interface and the command line interface. A graphical restore is an easy choice for most people. Let's start the recovery. You are asked to set up your keyboard and time zone, but you can skip this step. Your computer will automatically find your backup server in your local network. Your backup server found, it will ask for username and password. Because I want to keep my data safe, I have set up a password for your backup server. Here you select the client, backup version you want to restore. Restore, the data on your computer's hard drive will be destroyed. Depending on the backup image size and your local network speed, the recovery time is fast or slow. So my computer is restored, I will restart the computer. You can now remove the USB stick and set up your computer to boot from the hard drive. Windows computer has successfully restored from backup image on your backup server. You can also easily review your backup and restore history on your backups management page. What if you only want to backup certain files? Your backup can help you with that. On the Your Backup client, add the path to the directory where the files you want to backup are stored. Your backup can backup all or only the changes. With backup files, you can download directly on the Your Backup management page or store back to a folder on the client machine. Your backup can backup and restore over the internet. Hope you are interested in your backup, so I have the motivation to show how to backup and restore over the internet in the next video. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe.